Welcome back to the Make or Break Society. In this one, I'll be teaching you how to get RetroPie up and running on the Raspberry Pi 5. At the time of recording this, there's no official RetroPie image for the Pi 5, so we'll be doing a manual install. Now, let's get into it. Okay, so to install RetroPie, you're going to need one or two things. An SD card adapter or a USB micro SD card reader. And a keyboard if you're planning entering commands directly onto the Pi. I'll be using SSH, which means I won't need the keyboard. Now let's move on to our first step. Okay, so the first step is to fire up the Raspberry Pi Imager. If you don't have the Raspberry Pi Imager, you can get it by going to raspberrypi.com/software. I scroll down about halfway down, about a third of the way down the page, and download. You can download for Windows, Mac, or Ubuntu, or if you're using a Raspberry Pi to install this on a Raspberry Pi, you can download it there too. This would be an interesting method to do it, but it is doable. Once you've got it downloaded and installed, you'll be greeted with this screen. So we're going to choose device, Raspberry Pi 5, and we're going to choose our operating system. So we're going to choose Raspberry Pi OS Other. And we want Raspberry Pi OS Lite 64-bit. We're going to choose storage. So I'm going to plug in my micro SD card. And then choose storage. I'm going to pick that micro SD card and click next. Would you like to apply OS customizations? I'm going to go edit settings. So to keep this as much like an official RetroPie build as possible, I'm setting the host name to RetroPie, setting the username and password to Pi and Raspberry. And in here, you can also set up your Wi-Fi SSID and password. I'm going to set my locale settings, so America Regina, and then keyboard layout of US. If you don't set these, Wi-Fi won't automatically connect. And go to services, enable SSH, use password authentication. That just means that it's going to require that Pi username and the password of Raspberry. And options, eject media when finished. And click save. And then we're going to answer this as yes, and let it flash. All existing data will be erased. Are you sure you want to continue? Yes. Depending on the speed of your card, this will be pretty quick. But if you've got a slower card, this can take 5, even 10 minutes. This card is a really fast card, which is why it's writing so fast. Now we're on to verifying. If you don't want to let it verify, click cancel verify, the flashing will still succeed. It just means that it's not going to verify the integrity of the drive. I'm going to let it finish because it's fairly quick. Raspberry Pi OS Lite 64-bit has been written. You can now remove the SD card from the reader. So it's already ejected it, so now you can remove it. So we're going to remove it. Put it into the Pi, power it up, and I'll show you the boot up sequence for it. Okay, for step two, we're going to put the SD card into our Pi, plug in a display if you need one. Actually, don't need one for this step, but it makes getting the IP address a little easier, and power it on. So it's going to do a quick boot, and it's going to make your SSH keys, and then it's going to restart. And it's generating our keys. Now once it fully reboots, we're going to let it boot all the way up, and then after it's done that, we're going to need to grab the IP address. if you're not doing it with a screen attached, you'll have to either go into your router settings or use something like Advanced IP Scanner to find your IP. Okay, now that we're done booting, we'll look up a few lines here. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 lines up, or, you know, from that first okay. You'll see your IP address here. So in my case, it's 11.11.11.215. So make sure you make note of that. We're going to need that in our next step. And speaking of our next step, let's pop back over to the computer. All right, so on to step 3. So we're gonna open up PuTTY. We're gonna type in the IP address that we grabbed from step 2, or that you grabbed using either your router or advanced IP scanner or some other network scanner so you can find your IP address. We're gonna enter the one that we found. So it's 11.11.11.215. Port 22 is fine. We're going to click open. You're going to get a pop-up like this. You may get a pop-up like this. This is because I've done a lot of work on Raspberry Pis. This IP address has been used before, so it doesn't recognize the key. If you get this, just click accept. We're going to go log in as Pi. Password is the one we set in the imager, which is Raspberry. You'll notice that it didn't type anything there. It still types, it just doesn't show you that anything's being typed. Make this a little bit bigger for us. Alright, so now there's a couple of commands we need to run on here. I will link them in the description, but we're getting them from here. So retropie.org.uk/docs/manual-installation. So the first command we're going to run here is sudo apt update and sudo apt upgrade. I'm going to click copy there. Right click and it just pastes in. I'm going to click yes. And this is going to take a while. Apparently it's not going to take a while. I must have grabbed a newer version from the imager. That's good. Now let's head back over here. So we've already set our locale stuff. So we did that in the imager, so we can skip past that. So we're going to install RetroPie. I'll copy this first command. Paste. And yes. So what that did was copy the install files. What that did was copy the LSB release. The next one, we're going to download the setup script. So let's copy the setup script over. Execute the script. If I'm not mistaken, this does take a while. Actually, less time than I remembered. Yeah, so basically this is just a warning saying that, you know, it's not really designed to be installed this way, and, you know, everything's on you, essentially. Click OK. Warning, 64-bit support on Raspberry Pi is not yet officially supported, although the main emulator package selection should work. The new image isn't ready. Once it is ready, I'll make another video on the easy way to do this. Yeah, so let's go back to our instructions. So we want to manage packages. And then basic install, quick install. So we want basic install. This install, we click yes. And apparently there's no quick install question. Now I know this does take a while, so I'll speed this up and see you when it's done. Okay, so that took a little over an hour, which is why I didn't end up fast forwarding through it, I just cut it. Let's make this a little bit bigger. That's pretty much it. If you just want the most basic installation and you're good to go from there, that's it. If you want, you can go into like manage packages, for example. Or these are all the packages that are already on. Main. You can see that these packages are also already on. And then all your optional and whatnot packages. So if there's any other packages you want, like, you know, the Beetle PSX or PSPs in here as well, PPS, SPP, if you want any of them, you can install them now. Otherwise, don't reboot. First, go to configuration tools, then auto start, and start emulation station at boot. Emulation is set to launch at boot. Cool. And we can back out, go back. Now we can perform reboot and it'll start an emulation station. Now we'll pop over to my capture and I'll show you how she boots up. And finally, step four. This will look familiar to anybody who's used RetroPie before. This is identical to how a RetroPie image will boot up after fresh install. So from here, we plug in my PlayStation 4 controller and we set all the controls up. Set up with RetroPie. In my preliminary testing, everything functions exactly the same on the Pi 4 and the Pi 5, even though you get warnings that it's not designed for the Pi 5 yet and that it's not supported yet. I have noticed that some games, like God of War here, seem to run a little bit better or a little bit higher frame rate on the Pi 5. God of War seems to run at full speed, where it was just a little slow on the Pi 4. Well then, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't done so already. And until next time, remember, it doesn't matter if you make or break, as long as you're having fun.